Today's video, I want to cover with you Monte Carlo simulation. Monte Carlo simulation is used widely in fields such as engineering, physics, and finance. We'll cover how this intuitive framework can solve challenging probabilistic questions, and I'll show you how we can analyze a real problem using Monte Carlo in Python. And we'll do all of this in just over 5 minutes. So let's jump right into today's topic. To introduce Monte Carlo simulation, let's consider the following situation. It's 9 a.m. on a Thursday when your boss, Todd, comes into the office demanding that you have 2 reports on his desk by end of day. Now, let's just say that Todd is not the easiest boss to work for, but his demands today are particularly frustrating to you as you scheduled months ago a meetup with your friends and family that's taking place at 6 p.m. Now, for better or worse, you want to keep your job, but you also don't want to miss out on the event that's in just 9 hours. And so in pondering what to do next, you ask yourself, what is the chance that you could even finish these 2 reports in time for the party, and how could you actually even go about computing that chance? Now, to answer this question, we are going to rely on Monte Carlo simulation. And what's wonderful about this technique is that we can answer challenging probabilistic questions like this one with limited background actually in probability. So let's go back to our situation. Todd is expecting that you have 2 reports on his desk by end of day. Based on past experience, you're going to make a couple of guesses. These 2 reports will take anywhere between 1 to 5 and 2 to 6 hours respectively to complete, and your performance on one report has no bearing on the other. So those assumptions are going to inform the first step of Monte Carlo simulation, which is we will come up with some measure of uncertainty for each uncertain factor underlying our decision-making process. So based on a quick search online, you decide to represent the time to complete each report as following what's called a uniform distribution, which is a really intuitive idea. The probability distribution assumes the relative likelihood of all outcomes between a defined min and a defined max are the same. Now here is where the beauty and simplicity of Monte Carlo simulation comes into play. What we're going to do now is rely on a computer to randomly pick the time to complete each report. Those selected values are going to be based on our defined uniform distributions, which is why it is really important to make sure that you come up with a good estimate of those distributions at the start. Now let's speed this process up and do it maybe thousands, maybe millions of times. And we're going to store all of these randomly selected values, and once we do that, we can use those stored results to approximately estimate the distribution around the time to complete both reports, which we can now use to figure out the chance we'll make it to the party in time. And that's really the crux of Monte Carlo simulation. And so you can imagine for problems with many sources of uncertainty, Monte Carlo simulation provides a simple way to analyze complex systems. So to really appreciate Monte Carlo simulation, let's quickly show how you can implement it. And I'm going to do so in this video through Python. To first go about conducting our Monte Carlo simulation, we're going to rely on a library called NumPy, which has available functionality to conduct Monte Carlo simulation. So I'm going to import NumPy and propose that we do 1,000, let's just make it 1 million Monte Carlo simulations. And we'll do this for our 2 reports, which I'll refer to as being A and B. And they will take anywhere between 1 to 5 hours and 2 to 6 hours to complete. So let's define those values for the arguments for these functions. And of course, the total time to complete these 2 reports is simply their summation. So let's add them up, and voila. We now have 1 million random samples, which is great, but we now need to be able to use them to properly figure out the chance we'll make it to the party on time. So to do this, what I'll do now is bring in matplotlib, which I frequently rely on to visualize data. And what we're going to do once we've imported matplotlib is initialize a plot, which will be a histogram. And you'll notice that I set the argument density being equal to true so that we can plot everything in the form of probability densities. And let's also layer on top of this plot a vertical red line at the value 9 as the barbecue is in just 9 hours, making it a bit easier to visualize the probability the total time to complete both reports exceeds that threshold. And let's just do one more thing. After showing our plot, let's print the percentage of simulations that exceeded a total of 9 hours. We can do this by simply summing up the number of instances that meet a condition, in this case the time to complete exceeds 9 hours, and dividing it by the total number of simulations. And how cool is that? Without doing any hand calculations or derivations, you could pretty quickly estimate that there is a reasonable chance that you won't make it to the barbecue in 9 hours, around 12 to 13%. So, based on this probability, should you tell Todd to get lost? Should you take on these two reports, risking the chance that you'll miss out on the party? I'll leave that up to you. But what I can tell you is that Monte Carlo simulation is straightforward and intuitive and can be used to answer probability questions pretty simply with little required background knowledge of probability. And you can use this information to ultimately make the best choice for you. Now, if you've made it to the end of this video, definitely don't hesitate to subscribe to the channel if you're interested in learning more about this type of content. It definitely helps the channel reach and support a much broader community. And for those interested, I've included a link in the description to the code used in this video. Thank you as always for your interest and support. I look forward to seeing you soon.